بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، وأفضل الصلاة وأتم التسليم على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. اللهم لا سهل إلا ما جعلته سهلا، وأنت تجعل الحزن إذا شئت سهلا. ربي يسر لي أمري واشرح لي صدري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي، اللهم آمين. وبعد، أحبتي في الله، نكمل ما بدأنا به من الحديث في العدل، واليوم نتحدث كيف أن استقرار المجتمع يكون بالعدل، وهدمه وهلاكه يكون بالظلم. Dear brother and sister in Islam, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept from us, and I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to elevate our ranks in Jannah. Allahumma ameen. Today, inshallah, we'll continue speaking about justice, and we'll talk about today that how the growth and the security of the community is based on justice and the happiness of that community, and that the destroying of a community and its vanish, it's based on oppression, injustice. طيب، بعد أن بينا ما بينا من 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 مما في شرائع الإسلام من العدل، نأتي على خاتمة هذا الموضوع ونبين أن استقرار المجتمع يكون بالعدل وهلاكه يكون بالظلم. على الإنسان أن يجتهد في الإتيان بالعدل على وجهه، بتخليص قلبه من كل ما يشوبه من الشرك والهوى، واتباعا للنفس في سلطانها ونزواتها وشهواتها، لأن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول: واتقي دعوة المظلوم فإنه ليس بينها وبين الله حجاب. So a person should make his effort, make his best efforts in this dunya to establish justice. The first thing, the justice between you and yourself, by having a sincere heart towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. Do not have any kind of association with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You're not following your desire, you're not following your nafs. So after that, we have the statement of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and fear the supplication of the oppressed person, because there is no veil between him, between that supplication and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Meaning that if a oppressed person perform a dua against the one who oppressed him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will answer that dua. وَإِذَا تَظَالَمَ الْمُجْتَمَعِ فَصَارَ عَلَىٰ قِسْمَيْنِ إِمَّا ظَالِمْ أَوْ مَظْلُومٍ وتوفر المظلومون أناء الليل وأطراف النهار على الدعاء على ظلم الظالمين فسد أمر المجتمع وصار إلى تفكك وانهيار لأنه لا يقيم الأمر في الأرض إلا العدل ولا يؤسس ملك صحيح إلا على العدل. So if the community has a lot of oppression going on, so there will be two parties: the oppressed person and the one who is committing this oppression. So the oppressed person will start supplicating against those who oppressed them. So there is a lot of destruction and a lot of disasters will come to that community based on injustice, whatever is going there. Because whatever make the life goes easy and everything goes perfect is justice. And you cannot establish a perfect kingdom without having justice. والنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كان مستقرا عنده في دين ربه تبارك وتعالى أن العدل أساس الملك. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he knew from the religion, from the revelation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that in order to have a good community, a sound community, we have to establish it on justice. لما أرسل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم معاذا إلى اليمن رضي الله تعالى عنه كما في الصحيحين من رواية معاذ رضي الله تعالى عنه نفسه قال بعثني رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم فقال إنك تأتي قوما من أهل الكتاب فليكن أول ما تدعوهم إليه أن يشهدوا أن لا إله إلا الله وأني رسول الله فإن أطاعوا لذلك فأعلمهم أن الله قد فرض عليهم في اليوم والليلة 5 صلوات فإن أطاعوا لذلك فأعلمهم أن الله قد فرض عليهم في أموالهم صدقة تؤخذ من أغنيائهم وترد على فقرائهم وإياك وكرائم أموالهم واتق دعوة المظلوم فإنه ليس بينها وبين الله حجاب. هذا كان تأسيس الملك. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, when he sent Mu'adh رضي الله تعالى عنه to the people of Yemen at that time, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم told him, you will go to the people of the book. First, call them to testify that there is no true God except Allah and that I am Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the messenger of Allah. If they obey you, tell them that Allah has enjoined upon them 5 salah prayers during the day and night. And if they obey you, inform them that Allah has made zakah obligatory upon them, that it should be collected from the rich and distributed among their poor. And if they obey you, refrain from picking up as share of zakah the best of their wealth. Beware of the supplication of the oppressed, for there is no barrier between it and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is how the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told Mu'adh how to establish a kingdom, a country. ولا يعجبن أحد من تأسيس الدعوة إلى الله تبارك وتعالى على هذا الأصل الأصيل ضمن أصول. فإن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أمره بالبدء بالتوحيد تحقيقا ودعوة. فإن أجابوا فمظهر التوحيد في الاستسلام لله العزيز المجيد بالإتيان بما فرض بأن يأتوا بالصلوات على وجهها وأن يخرجوا حق المال. ثم أخرج النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ما أخرج من أصل عظيم على سبيل التحذير بقوله وإياك وكرائم أموالهم واتق دعوة المظلوم فإنه ليس بينها وبين الله حجاب. لأن الله جل وعلا يقبل ويستجيب دعوة المظلوم ولو كان كافرا, فإن الله تبارك وتعالى حرم الظلم على نفسه وجعله بين العباد محرما. So when you look at this great hadith, you see how the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the first thing that he started with, it is the call of the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the call of at-tawheed. And if they accepted that, it is from the basic of tawheed to surrender totally to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that will be by performing the 5 salawat, by giving their zakah. But then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him, be aware from taking their wealth out, and be aware from the supplication of the oppressed person, because there will be no barrier between it and between Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he will answer the supplication of the oppressed person even if he is not a Muslim, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made oppression unlawful upon himself, and he made it unlawful between his servants. فأرشد الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم معاذا رضي الله تعالى عنه وهو يؤسس للأمر الأول على منهاج النبوة في اليمن, أرشده إلى هذا الأصل الأصيل وحذره النبي الكريم من الظلم ظاهرا وباطنا. وإن الذي ينخر في جميع بين آيات الأمة في جميع أحوالها وفي جميع مددها إنما هو الظلم. So the Prophet ﷺ, when he sent Mu'adh to al-Yaman to establish a place of Islam there, he started with Tawheed, but then he told him to be aware from oppression. And he taught, because whatever destroy the nations before us, if we read in history, you will see that every nation that was destroyed and it was vanished, it was because the oppression. أما إذا أسس الأمر على العدل فأبشر بأمة قائمة عزيزة مستبشرة بنصر الله رب العالمين. لأن الله تبارك وتعالى لا يؤيد ظالما، وإنما يخذله ويقتص منه ويقيم عليه الأمر دنيا وآخرة. So if it was the country or the nation was established based on justice, then you will have the glad tiding of having a victorious nation that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala supported, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not support the oppression, the oppressors, those who oppressed people, and he does not grant him victory. But indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will punish him in this dunya and in the hereafter. قال جل وعلا وَلَقَدْ أَهْلَكْنَا الْقُرُونَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَمَّا ظَلَمُوا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Yunus, verse number 13, that we've destroyed the nations before you when they committed injustice. وَالظُّلْمُ عُقُوبَتُهُ مُعَجَّلَةٌ وَالظُّلْمُ عُقُوبَتُهُ يَشْمَلُ يعني الظلم العقوبة المعجلة هذه تشمل ظلم الأفراد بعضهم بعضا إذا أصبح ظاهرا فاشيا بين الناس، وظلم الدول لرعاياها، ويندرج تحته الظلم الاجتماعي والسياسي والاقتصادي. والملوك والسلاطين أكثر الناس معرفة بعواقب الظلم الوخيمة، ولهم كلمات تشهد بذلك. So oppression, the punishment of oppression, we either it will happen in this dunya or in the hereafter. If it happens in this dunya, it will happen for two sides of people. First, when people commit oppression against each other, and this become as a sign of this community that they oppressed each other, or when the country oppressed the citizen of that country, whether it was by economic or politician or whatever. If they commit any kind of injustice, they will pay for that, and the kings and the people and responsibilities, they know that doing and committing oppression, it will bring to them their defeat one day. قال شيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية رحمه الله تعالى إن الناس لم يتنازعوا في أن عاقبة الظلم وخيمة وعاقبة العدل كريمة. ولهذا يروى أن الله ينصر الدولة العادلة ولو كانت كافرة، ولا ينصر الدولة الظالمة وإن كانت مؤمنة. So, Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah, may Allah have mercy on his soul, he said, the people has no doubt that the end of oppression, it's a bad ending. And the one who does justice, he will have a happy life and a good life and a secure life. So that's why it was narrated that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant victory to the country if it is justice, even if they are not Muslim. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bring defeat to the country that commit injustice, even if they are Muslim. وأمور الناس تستقيم في الدنيا مع العدل الذي فيه الاشتراك في أنواع الإثم أكثر مما تستقيم أمورهم مع الظلم في الحقوق وإن لم تشترك في إثم. يعني أمور الناس تستقيم في الدنيا مع العدل الذي فيه الاشتراك في أنواع الإثم. يعني أحيانا قد تقوم أمور دولة معينة قائمة على العدل حتى وإن كانت هناك بعض المعاصي. لكن لن تستقيم أمورهم إذا كان هناك الظلم وإن ابتعدوا عن باقي المعاصي. لهذا قيل إن الله يقيم الدولة العادلة وإن كانت كافرة، ولا يقيم الدولة الظالمة وإن كانت مسلمة. والدنيا تدوم مع العدل والكفر، ولا تدوم مع الظلم والإسلام. So that and the life will be established and everything will be based on security and everything will be good if the life is based on justice. Even if there are some persons here and there, they commit some sins, but still they are just between each other. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will help that country. But the things will not work out for those who are based on oppression and injustice, even if they don't commit any kind of sin beside oppression. And that's why they said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will help in having the country if it is justice, even if they are not Muslim, and vice versa will happen if they are injustice and they are Muslim, their life will not be established on security. And that the dunya will be established for those who are just, even if they commit kufr, and it will not be established with injustice and oppression, even if they are Muslim. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ليس ذنب أسرع عقوبة من البغي وقطيعة الرحم. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said that there is no sin that brings the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala faster than oppression and then cutting the ties of kin, the kin ties. So that will be it inshallah for today, and inshallah tomorrow we'll continue speaking, and tomorrow inshallah will be the last lesson or the last lecture about justice, and maybe inshallah after that we'll start with a new series about a new topic inshallah. But inshallah tomorrow we'll continue speaking about what we start about today inshallah. And until tomorrow, I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to benefit all of us, and I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect all of you, and I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to gather us inshallah soon in the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahumma ameen. Sallallahu wa sallam wa baraka ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.